Goldie, you fell. You fell like 50. Wait, look at me.
Is it bad?
No.
Do I have a bruise?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, you'll be all right.
Are you sure?
Oh fuck, this is hard to do in a car.
Push
my
it.
Titties out.
Hurry,
bitch, you don't have time? Oh no, the curves are gonna
hurry,
see.
Hurry,
my
hurry.
Mom doesn't walk in right now. This better look good. Nice.
Oh nah, bruh. You one of them XD RAR bitches? Emo ass.
Don't worry. You will become a chick magnet with our magnetic septum rings. They don't hurt while wearing them, they don't fall out, and you can wear them as long as you want. Whether you have strict parents or just want to see what you'd look like with a septum piercing, our rings are perfect. Shop now before we run out of stock.
Oh my god, are you kidding me? What do you think I learned all this
it's
shit?
Just a
My mom says she wants to take me to the store. You know what that means.
It's time to make her wish she took birth control.
Hogwarts houses are really just how you dealt with trauma as a child. Hufflepuffs are accommodators. Yell at them and they'll be quiet in the hopes that you stop yelling.
Use face zoom to see what you look like. Oh my god! Well, I did that. Wait!
So I get off stage, right, drop the mic, walk up to these hot chicks and I'm all like, "Sup, ladies, my name's Slim Shady, I'm the lead singer of D12, baby." They're all like, "Oh my god, it's him, Becky, oh my freaking god, it's him, I swear to freaking god, dude, you freaking rock, please, don't you please let me stick it." And then by now, the rest of the fellas get jealous, especially when I drop the beat and do my acapellas. All the chicks start yelling, all the hot babes, all the bras and the shirts and the panties on stage, so like every single night they pick a fight with me. But when we fight, it's kinda like sibling rivalry, cause they're back on stage the next night with me. Dude, I just think they're trying to steal the light from me. Yep.
Smack girl, I think you dropped something. My jaw.
Why'd you give that homeless man money? You know he's just gonna spend it on drugs, right? To be fair, so was I, and I have a home, so like...
On the bar, this goes to the strippers and the fucking porn stars and them sexy motherfuckers showing shit on the bar.
Okay, so story time. This might be a little bit of a two-parter, but when I was in sixth grade, I used to wear my goddamn it, you know, the little emo sleeves or whatever, and because I did used to self-harm, and then I was walking to class one day, and I don't know how the fuck my teacher knew, I guess, you know, telltale red flag signs, but he, like, just rolled my sleeve down one day and was like, you know, they can send you to the mental hospital for that, and I was like, no, they can't. Leave me alone. Like, shut the fuck up talking to me. So then I went in the classroom, and I'm just sitting there chilling or whatever. Fast forward, freshman year of high school, I've been living in North Carolina with my dad. Listen, their relationship was not hitting at all. Anyway, so I'm sitting outside the English room crying, bawling my eyes out because she called my dad on me talking about I was sleeping in the motherfucking classroom, and that I wasn't cooperating. So she's kicked me out the classroom. So I'm crying in the hallway. And then like some principal walked by. He's like, hey, what's wrong? What's going on with you? I let him know like, yeah, I'm about to go home and get in trouble. She just called my dad. He about to beat my ass when I get home. Like it's a wrap. So he's like,
don't you know that you're toxic?
Cutting my hair because exams are this week. Ignore the blind end.